Good morning, everybody. This is breakfast time again. Hallelujah. Happy new week and happy stress-free week in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. By the special grace of God, today I won't waste much of your time. I'm going to share with us from our last month's meeting, Women on the Mission. Hallelujah. It was theme, pray with our season. Hallelujah. Pray with our season. Jesus, our perfect example, started with prayer and he ended up with prayer. Hallelujah. And let's see what he told us in the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 1. He said, Jesus told them a story showing that it was necessary for them to pray constantly and never to quit. Jesus was telling them a story, making them, what was the story? He was talking about the story of a widow and the unjust judge that fears not even man or God. But because this woman constantly persisted for the judge to avenge her, and what happened, the judge definitely finally have avenged her and said, let me avenge this woman or else she wearies me. Hallelujah. That was what the woman did. And Jesus used this illustration to say, pray without ceasing. In other words, pray until that which you are praying for is physically manifested in your hands. Yes. And the book of Luke 22, when we look at 40 and 41, this is what Jesus was saying again. He said, here he told them, pray that you will not be overcome by temptation. Pray that you will not be overcome by temptation. In other words, if you don't pray, you will be overcome by temptation. But pray that you are not overcome by temptation. In 41, this is what he said. He said, he walked away about a stone throne and he knelt down and pray. Jesus, our perfect example, knelt down and pray. The Son of the Living God knelt down and pray. And who are you that you won't say you are not? Hey, Jesus has done everything for you, so you just need to go. You just need to walk on your own. And this is what 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 17 told us through his servant Apostle Paul. He said, pray without what? Ceasing. So in other words, what is prayer? Prayer is communication. Communication between humanity, I beg your pardon, and divinity. Though the dictionary says it's between people and their deity. Hallelujah. It's between humanity and divinity. And I have also said in the write-up I'm putting together, I said every solid relationship has a solid foundation called communication. Look at it. When you constantly relate with somebody, one particular person, you relate with the person very, very often, you find that your relationship is more solidified. Your relationship is more better than the way it was when you had little or no communication. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. And I want to quickly say, in life that we are, if you must succeed, you must be that prayerful type. You must be that prayerful type. If you must succeed, you must develop the attitude of praying over and over and over again. Hallelujah. If Jesus said pray without ceasing, if Jesus said pray, don't quit, then why are you sitting there and said you have prayed? No, keep praying until the results come. He said that widow, when you look at that Luke chapter 18, the widow from verse 1, the widow began to trouble the unjust judge until what her desire was given unto her. Hallelujah. And Jesus said, pray, don't quit. Amen. The life we are today, it is the spiritual that controls the physical. It is the spiritual that controls the physical. So as a child of God, you have given the keys of the kingdom. You have given authority to trample upon serpent and scorpion. You have given the keys of the kingdom that declares whatsoever you bind on earth is bind in heaven. Therefore, you need to pray. If you don't pray, nothing will happen. I remember a famous preacher said, if there is a mouth to pray, if there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. So when you develop the attitude of prayer, you find out that you will not be overcome. Hallelujah. Even if, as Jesus was praying, Jesus had to go through some situations. Even the apostles of old, though they were praying, but they still had to go through challenges. Have you ever sat down to imagine if they had not prayed at all? What would have been their fate? Hallelujah. And look at what the book of Philippians 4 verse 6 told us. He said, be anxious for nothing. Be anxious for nothing. Don't be afraid. Don't be threatened. But through prayers and supplication and thanksgiving, through prayers, supplication and thanksgiving, what? Let your request be known. Through prayers, he emphasized emphasize again that prayer is very, very important. Prayers cannot be overemphasized. Prayers cannot be taken away out of the life of a Christian. Prayer cannot be taken out of Christianity. So you must be a prayerful type. He said they overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. What was the word of their testimony? Their prayers. Hallelujah. So you must develop that attitude. You must develop that attitude as that attitude of prayer as a child of God. The fastest way for a person to die quickly is when you stop praying. Hallelujah. When you stop praying, in fact, it is an express way. Hallelujah. I say people fail in mission because they fail to pray. Yes, you might have a vision, but it is your prayer that is going to direct you through. Hallelujah. It is your prayer that is going to direct you true. People that prays without ceasing enjoy communication with God. Enjoy communication with God. Why? Because why? They understand that surely there is a God that answers. There is a God that heareth them. Praise Master Jesus. It is dangerous to embark into a thing with a personal idea without seeking God, without praying. It is dangerous to embark on spiritual vacation. The Bible says in the book of Matthew, it said, when men slept, our enemy came to sort us. Yes, let me tell you, when man took spiritual vacation and said, okay, I will not pray again. Everything is done. Grace has covered everything. The enemy came to sort us. People that preach to us about grace, Apostle Paul and every other apostles, they encourage us to keep praying. My brothers, my sister, yes, it is possible to pray without ceasing. Yes, there are some prayers you pray verbally. There are some that you pray in your heart, whereby your heart is constantly communicating with God. Hallelujah. So you must develop that habit as you go through this week. Constantly communicate with your Father. Constantly communicate with God. Communicate with Him, and you will see Him fix things up for you. Hallelujah. And now with this, I would want to round up. By the special grace of God, we will continue. Persist in the place of prayer. Persist in the place of prayer. When you persist in the place of prayer, you see results coming. No wonder the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy that comes from the presence of God is my strength. You might see people the way they are physically, they are not, there is nothing to celebrate with them for. But when you see them, you don't see that trace in them that these ones are, they don't have anything to celebrate. But you see the joy of the Lord, you see the boldness, you see the glory of God radiating. That's what prayer can do. In the place of prayer, revelations are given. In the place of prayers, visions are bettered. Hallelujah. Visions are bettered. And I pray God Almighty to empower us, that at the end of this series, it's going to be a series by God's grace. Next week, we're still going to talk about it quickly. That at the end of this series, every one of us will rise up to our altar of prayer. And I pray that the fire in the altar of our prayers will not go down in the name of Jesus. That fire that burns in our altar of prayers will not be quenched in Jesus Christ's name. So I will not fail to invite you to our Women on the Mission program coming up this month ending. We know every last Saturday of the month we have our meetings in Pamplona, except we have something else outside Pamplona, 23 of this month. So if you reside within Pamplona, Navarra, Victoria, be our guest. We are expecting to see you in Jesus Christ's name. So have a stress-free week, and God bless you really good. Remember, Jesus says, pray without quit. God bless you. Bye-bye for now. Hallelujah.